Hello and welcome back to this AI Coffee Break. Grab your favorite coffee cup because we've got exciting news. Diffusion models can finally produce text that doesn't look like a coffee bean walked across the keyboard. We all know diffusion models have been generating jaw-dropping images, audio, and even videos. And if you want a refresher of how diffusion models work, we've got you covered. Since we have already done explainers about diffusion models before, see the video description for pointers. But so far, diffusion models have been really bad at generating text. Check out this word salad from an autoregressive diffusion model. But fear not, discrete diffusion models are finally here to generate text that looks like this. It's much more coherent and it finally looks like GPT-style LLMs get a worthy competitor from diffusion models. So in this video, we're diving into the paper that finally did it. We've gone through all the equations-heavy pages and have simplified and distilled the most important bits of knowledge and insights for you. For more knowledge and even hands-on practical experience related to artificial intelligence, while you're waiting for the next AI Coffee Break episode, check out Simplilearn's comprehensive AI course in collaboration with IBM. This course covers essential AI skills through industry-relevant training, live interactive sessions, and hands-on projects. You'll learn or refresh your knowledge of Python, Flask, Scikit-Learn, Keras, TensorFlow, and even more. And trust me, this is way more practical application than many universities have to offer. And upon completion, you'll earn a certification from IBM, which you can put in your CV to help you land your next job. Simplilearn is a fantastic resource, not just for AI, but for a wide range of topics. It's a premier online learning platform offering bootcamps and courses to help you advance your career in AI, software development, cybersecurity, and more. The next cohort in Simplilearn's AI course is starting soon with limited seats, so make sure to secure your spot. Visit the link in the description below or check the pinned comment to explore Simplilearn and take the first steps towards advancing your career through online education. So far, diffusion models conquered the domains of images, video, audio, but could not yet produce high-quality text. But it would be so great if diffusion models could produce good text, because they have the potential to be better than autoregressive language models like the GPT family. GPTs can only continue prompts linearly, predicting the next word one after the other. Diffusion models can generate text with prompts positioned anywhere. Prompts can be in the beginning and middle or even split across the text. This opens so many ways for controlling the generation. But why is it so easy to produce images with diffusion models, but text is so hard? Maybe you remember that training data for diffusion models is generated by adding more and more noise to pictures in a certain number of steps, like 100, until the picture is just noise. This is called the forward diffusion process. Then the diffusion model trains to predict the noise we need to subtract to denoise the image, basically doing the backwards diffusion process. The noising and denoising is a simpler task with images and other continuous modalities such as video or sound. There we can add continuous Gaussian noise and the images change smoothly into noise and back. And with Gaussians, the math becomes nice and efficient, such that the model does not need to make too many predictions per sample while learning the backward diffusion process. But text is very different, as it is symbolic and discrete in nature. Noising tokens would mean to replace them with random tokens or to mask them. Jumps from one stage in the noising process to the next can be at most as many as there are tokens in the sequence, while with images we can go as fine-grained as necessary. A solution to the problem is a discrete diffusion, as presented in this paper and work that came before it. Instead of doing diffusion on tokens directly, the idea is to do diffusion on each token's probability vector that represents a token's chance of being a specific token from the vocabulary. Of course, in the beginning, these probabilities are 1 for the word in the training sequence and 0 for the remaining 50,000 tokens in the vocabulary. Here, for the visualization, we imagine that the vocabulary is only 4 tokens large, containing the words from the sentence and a mask token, which could also be other random words in the vocabulary if we want to noise with random words. And now, with this continuous representation between 0 and 1 for our tokens, the idea is to do diffusion. These 0 and 1s still look like they're discrete, but they're not, because look, if the model predicts these soft probabilities, it also counts as correct predictions, and we could measure with cross entropy how close the model is to the correct prediction and train it with such a loss function. Wait, this sounds familiar, because this is exactly what the BERT mask language model does. So in a sense, yes, BERT is a discrete diffusion model, but there are some clear and important differences. BERT is trained only with a 15% mask tokens rate, whereas diffusion models train with a range from 0% to 100% mask tokens. In other words, if you want to generate sequences with BERT and we give it a lot of mask tokens as input, this is already out of distribution and BERT will perform badly since it has never seen so many mask tokens in its sequence during training. But maybe the most important difference between BERT and discrete diffusion models lies in their loss functions. BERT uses standard cross entropy to make the model learn to unmask mask tokens by predicting the probabilities over the entire vocabulary based on the surrounding context. Discrete diffusion models take a different approach, requiring a different loss function because they adopt a more mathematically rigorous perspective on the entire process, similar to how diffusion models typically operate. So let's go into the details. The forward diffusion process generates training data by producing noisier and noisier samples, which the diffusion model must later denoise. The process looks like this. At each noising step, the authors randomly pick a token and multiply its probability vector PT by a matrix Q resulting in PT plus 1, representing altered probabilities. For example, a special structure of the matrix Q would make the probabilities represent a random word. Alternatively, the authors also choose masking as a noising strategy, and here the matrix Q has a special structure to set all probabilities to zero except for the mask token, like we have depicted here in this example. So this is what the authors mean by equation 1 in the paper. It represents the diffusion equation saying that the change, so the flipped token, is caused by a linear transformation Q onto the token's probabilities in forward diffusion. Now, backward diffusion only needs to find the matrix Q bar that multiplied to PT plus 1 reproduces the original probabilities PT. Sounds simple enough, especially because the inversion matrix turns out to be a probability ratio times the original matrix Q. But in the paper, this is written quite intimidatingly, so let's write it more practically. Here, like this. Let's take a step back and see what we have. We ran forward diffusion to get the samples with noise levels T and T plus 1. The only difference between them is one token that has been noised or masked, here cat. Now, to revert the process, we need to take the ratio between the probabilities PT plus 1 and PT. This probability ratio is called the concrete score, and we multiply it to the original diffusion matrix Q to revert the diffusion process. Now, all we need to do is let the model learn to predict the concrete score. This is why in the paper this is denoted as S theta, because we parameterize S with the model. The authors teach a transformer model to output the concrete score. They can't do this because in the training data we have the probabilities which we just produced with the matrix Q in the forward diffusion, so we can just calculate the score. With a cross-entropy-like loss function, the authors teach the transformer diffusion model to output the score as well. Because once it learned to predict this score, we can use it to generate text during inference, starting from a sequence where all probabilities are uniformly noisy or masked. But for the prompt tokens, the discrete diffusion model denoises the sequence token by token by picking a token and for it predicting the concrete score S. We then multiply the concrete score S to the forward diffusion matrix Q, multiply to the noisy probabilities in PT plus 1, and we get the probability of the predicted token. Doing this token after token produced the final sequence. To speed up the generation process, the authors could generate multiple tokens simultaneously, but this would impact the results negatively. We see here that the less denoising steps, the higher the perplexity. But all in all, we can see that SEDD, the discrete diffusion models the authors trained with the score entropy loss, delivers perplexities comparable to GPT-2. Here, SEDD absorb refers to the discrete diffusion model with masking, while SEDD uniform is noising with random words. Most importantly, SEDD is much better than prior text diffusion models. While this is not quite ChatGPT's level, the authors achieved this with a 320 million parameter model, which is similar in size to the 340 million parameters of GPT-2, which is impressive for diffusion models that so far generated really bad text. It remains to be seen whether future work will be able to scale diffusion models in terms of size, speed, and generation quality to surpass GPT-2. Wow, after all this math, I can't believe that you're still here. If you're interested in knowing even more, check out the paper and also a talk by Aaron Liu, the first author of the paper. We'll leave a pointer in the description below. Thanks for watching, and to enjoy your coffee breaks with our next videos, don't forget to hit the like and subscribe buttons.